Hi everybody, today we are going to see about Lingkyo, that is Language Integrated Query. Let's come to intro. A query is nothing but a statement which is used to retrieve data from data source. Okay. There are so many queries available, query languages available in the market, and those query languages are developed for dedicated data sources. For example, SQL for relational databases, SQuery for XML. Okay, we can use SQL with relational database only, not XML or object in the .NET we are used. At the same time, XQuery for XML only, we cannot use XQuery for relational databases. Over here, the advantage of Lingkyo is nothing but we can use Lingkyo to XML as well as relational databases in the form of entity frameworks and the data sources like in a generic list, array, whatever used in our framework. Okay, this is short and sweet introduction for Lingkyo. To use Lingkyo, it provides lot of operators. Operators nothing but a keyword as like an SQL statement. We can use select statement here with a projection operator. Where conditions comes under restriction and grouping, set, ordering and aggregate. So these are the operators available in our Lingkyo. Okay, let's start with the most frequently used operators in the Lingkyo, that is projection, restriction, grouping, aggregate and ordering. Projection is nothing but selecting the column. We may select single column or we may select multiple columns, that is select many. Okay, then restriction is nothing but conditions. For condition we have to use where keyword. Then grouping, group by columns, group by multiple columns also possible here. And aggregation is nothing but aggregation functions in mathematics like sum, count, minimum, maximum and average. Then ordering is nothing but sorting. We can sort using ascending or descending. We require descending, then we need to specify descending explicitly. Then by is nothing but we are going to use multiple column ordering, then we need to use then by. These are used in extension method. So assume that we are going to order and order by descending. Okay, these are the steps involved in Lingkyo operations. Steps nothing but we need to select a data source. Data source might be database or XML document, generic list or array, whatever it may be. So we need to select the data source, okay, and create a query. A query with the combination of operators which we require and execute. Execution part nothing but the query execution. Okay. Assume that we are having the data source. We are going to implement this table in a generic list. Employee ID, name, gender, age, and short code. Okay, these are the properties in the class, and these are the instances of the class. Okay, let's come to the implementation. We are going to use projection operator here. Projection operator nothing but the selection from a particular column. We are using single column selection. Formally we use select a column name from table, that alias name. For code simplification we can use alias name. This is a simple SQL statement for selecting single column from the table. Here the from, in, select, these are the operators. The operators that is in Lingkyo should be in lower case, not in uppercase or camel case. Okay, from e, that is an alias name. Assume that we are having the list collection with the employee information. Then we are going to select employee name from employee info. Okay, the result will be look like this. Only the employee name from the data table, that is table, will be displayed, comes in the result. We can store it as var type variable or a list of string. Okay, anyway we require. Let's assume we required two columns from the data source, so that we need to use a select many concept. For that the selection that is from is same. And we need to introduce select new the column name. We should give the column name because this is a dynamic object, it should understand by the column name. This emp name equal to e dot employee name, nothing but the employee name from the employee info. Then age is another column name. We are assigning the e dot age into age, so that we will retrieve the result in the form of employee name and age. Okay. Let's come to restriction operator. Restriction operator, nothing but a condition. We are going to select the data from data source with certain conditions. So that is a condition or here called a restriction from e in employee info. That is nothing but we are going to retrieve data from employee info. Each employee info, employee information will transform into e. Then the condition is we are going to retrieve only the male information, that is male employee name. Okay, in the where class e that gender equal to male, so we are given a single quote because which is a character type, e dot gender double equal to m, that is employee who are all in male gender will be filtered. Then projecting the employee name with male employee names only will be retrieved. This is restriction operator. Grouping and aggregation. Grouping, nothing but we are going to group based on the column, retrieving the information with aggregation. So what we do in SQL, we required gender wise count of employees. We use select gender comma count of star from the employee database. Then we use group by keyword. Group by, then in which column based we are going to group, that is e dot gender. The same in link queue, from e dot in employee info we are going to group e, that is instance name, by column name, which column wise we are going to group gender. Grouped result will be stored into grp, that's a new object. The all the group information will store into grp. From that we are going to select many information, nothing but gender, in which we are group gender. Okay, the gender information will be a key of the group item, and employee count, nothing but the group information comes in key, and the resulted column will be in the list form. So we are going to take a count of genders. The result will be gender female 4 employees and male 5 employees. Okay. Then ordering nothing but sorting. We used here order by the column name, based on which column we are going to be sort. If we required in the descending order, then we can use order by the column name we are going to sort in the form of descending. See the result over here. Behind this there are two query execution types, nothing but deferred query and immediate query. Deferred query, nothing but we are going to select particular data from the data source and which will be manipulated later on. In the immediate query we are going to retrieve data with the help of aggregation function, for example summation or count or minimum or maximum, whatever it may be. That's called immediate query. Deferred query, nothing but selecting the data for further operation. Let's come to the demo. We should use system.linkQ as a namespace for linkQ manipulation. Assume that we have the person class with 5 columns. Okay, these are the person class, and we used a sample data context for sample data creation. We have the list of person, and this will create instance of 9 persons data. Okay, which will return the list of persons. List of person, this is a list employee, and sample context dot get sample data is nothing but it will retrieve list of employees. This concept demonstrate the simple select statement from e in list employee, select employee name, that is we are going to retrieve on the employee name from the employee information, and we are going to display the result into console. Okay, let's run the code. Okay, it will retrieve all the employee information from the data source and display it in a console. Okay, this is for simple selection. It's come to the multiple column selection. But we need to implement a new object, and we need to give the column name. Based on the given column name only, the dynamic object will be created, so that we can easily manipulate with the object. The var nothing but dynamic object based on the new statement will be created. Okay, so we are going to select employee name as well as the age from the data source. Then come to where it is restriction. Over here we are going to select the male employee name only. Okay, so that we are going to choose the data source, and condition is nothing but and e dot gender equal to male, which is character type enclosed with a single quotation, and selected only the employee name. This will display the male employee information only. Okay, here we are going to implement grouping as well as aggregation function. Okay, we selected the data source, that is employee, and we are going to group based on gender. Grouped information will be stored in GRP, that is a new object. In this object only we can retrieve further information. Okay, we cannot use if over here, because it's all everything grouped into GRP. GRP contains list of employees information based on the grouping. Over here we just require counts of employee, so that used to GRP.count, which will return the count based on the grouping. So it display 5 employees are in the male and 4 employees are female. Grouping as well as aggregation function and order by descending. Order by ascending is the default. We are going to retrieve data from an employee and going to order by the employee name and select the employee. Here the same thing happened, but we have specified explicitly descending. That means we are going to order by descending by names. So these are the ascending order information, employee information, and this will be descending order. I hope you are all enjoyed the beginner session. Thank you.